Hi again, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm. I'm sitting here amongst my miniature roses, and I'm going to say about them that most of them are hardy to zones 5 and 6. And when I say that, I take it for granted that most of you will know exactly what I mean. That cold hardiness is baked into the way that we look at plants in North America, certainly. But what does it mean, and is it reliable? And maybe even the better underlying question is it cold that kills your plants over the winter after all? And my answer to that, my argument for that in this video is not as often as you might think. But we can't go much further without at least doing a brief recap of those climate zones that I just talked about. One of the first, and still the most widely accepted, at least in North America, of these hardiness zones is the USDA zone maps. If you look on their site, you can see this map, and the way that you're intended to use it is to find yourself on the map, and what it will do is it will give you a hardiness zone, or assign to your area a hardiness zone. So for instance, if you're in zone 6, they expect that the coldest temperatures that you will on average have in that zone is negative 10 degrees Fahrenheit, and there's obviously Celsius conversions to this, and Canada more or less followed the lead of the USDA, so they have their own hardiness maps based on these same zones. Now, if you were in zone 6 and you are expecting negative 10 Fahrenheit, then other parties could go in and fill in the blanks as to what plants are expected to survive in that area. So the botanical gardens and the trial gardens of big horticulture would go and they would test the plants, and then they would assign the plant a matching zone. So if you're in zone 6 and the plant is rated for zone 6, you have a win. Also, if the plant is rated for zone 5 or 4 or 3, it's rated to accept cold that is deeper than your cold, and so you can choose from amongst those plants. So those of us lucky enough to live in a good climate zone, zone 8, zone 9, can choose from a wide range of plants, whereas if you're living in zone 3, you know that your selection is a little bit more narrow. Sadly, the hardiness zone won't tell you for sure that your plant will survive a season. In fact, the number one reason why plants die over the winter, in my experience, has been their overall health and vigor, their condition going into the season. If the cold didn't kill them, then they would have been killed by another environmental stressor. They could have been killed by drought. They could have been killed by disease. There's lots of ways that a plant can die in the landscape, and this time it just happened to be the cold. So I will give you my experience over the last year is that last year we had a deep cold after Christmas in our farm, and all of my roses were rated to survive those temperatures. I mean, they would have been fine to the slightly deeper temperature that we had, but three of them died. Now, if you'd asked me ahead of time which three roses are in trouble in your field, those are exactly the three I would have named. They were ones that were weak, thin, poorly established in the ground, struggling anyway, and the winter just happened to be the thing that tipped them over. Was it the deep cold? You know, they were hardy to those zones. It could have been just that they ran out of energy before the spring came up. Remember, plants store energy in their tissues. Once they drop all their leaves, they can't photosynthesize anymore. They have limited stores of energies. Those plants that are strong and healthy and have been growing well have stored enough energy to get through the winter. Those that are weak and struggling haven't. So the first thing you need to consider before you talk about winterization or hardiness zones is the condition of your plants themselves. Are they growing well? And of course, you can react to this earlier in the season by saying, well, if this plant isn't doing well, it's in a pot, maybe I'll leave it in a pot. I won't put it in the landscape to struggle over the winter. Maybe I'll leave it in the pot, give it some babying over the winter, or bring it back to health next spring and season, and I really won't leave it to the stress of winter until I have it well established. I'm going to rank winter wet as the number two reason why plants die over the winter. Certainly here in the damp Pacific Northwest, it by far outstrips the direct impact of deep cold, is the fact that roots are sitting in moisture over the winter and the plant just doesn't have enough access to oxygen to fuel itself. What you will see oftentimes in the descriptions of plants in catalogs is doesn't like wet feet or requires excellent drainage. These are clues to you that you better assess that before the winter season. What's funny about the plant hardiness zones is that some plants that are considered, that, for instance, dahlias, that say that you have to dig and lift these out of the ground, and the primary reasons why they have to come out of the ground doesn't have to do with the cold itself. In fact, I've seen some videos recently, and maybe I'll see if I can put in at least a link, but maybe if I can get a clip as well, of a dahlia grower who actually overwinters her dahlias in the ground just by covering them over with a mulch and then getting a tarp over top of that to keep the wet out. It's such an important thing. Now, imagine a situation where you've got a plant in a container or a rose in a container, say, and you've stuck that up against the house thinking that's going to protect it from all that cold and wind, and yet from the side of your roof is coming down a stream of water that's filling that up with water and keeping it in mushy soil or soggy soil all the way through the winter season, it's not going to be a surprise to you when you come back and find that that's dead in the spring. Certainly the other thing you can do is have an assessment around your landscape during the summer or fall when you see that there are drainage problems, and to try to address those or move those plants before you go into the winter, because aside from, say, you know, willows and dogwoods and a few of those sort of boggy type shrubs, there isn't a lot that likes to have wet feet over the course of the winter. The third reason why allegedly cold hardy plants might die over the course of a winter has a bit to do with wind, or rather the effects of wind, which is desiccation. And I invite you to think for a second about why it is that an unheated greenhouse like this offers any protection at all. Certainly it reaches all of the same cold temperatures as the outdoor. There's no extra heat in here. What it is doing is it's cutting down, certainly, you know, it's got that roof on there, so it's cutting down on the moisture, so I have more control over the moisture. So that addresses the last thing I talked about, but it also cuts down on the wind. And wind that is cold, air that is cold, doesn't hold a lot of moisture. What it does is as it pushes past the leaves and through the leaves and stems of your plants, is it actually sucks the moisture out of them. That's why sometimes you will see this scene where you've had, say, snow cover across your shrubs, let's say your roses here, and the winter winds have come and gone, and you come to the spring and you look, and at almost a uniform level across a whole bunch of roses, you see black stems above where the snow line was. That's the effect of having a wind come through and suck the moisture out of those stems. Certainly in a climate like mine, where we don't have reliable snow cover, there are certain plants that are more vulnerable to this. Think about plants that go fully dormant. Of course, they don't have the foliage to suck that moisture out of, but think of something like a lavender or a rosemary, and how many of those have maybe you lost in a climate like this, because they tend to hold on to those needles or leaves over the winter, and then of course when it gets that cold wind come through, it just sucks the moisture of that plant and kills them to the ground. So if you can provide for certainly for more sensitive plants, if you can provide some shelter from wind, it's great. If you have a greenhouse like this, that's great. Out in the landscape, you can do a lot by putting some burlap around and maybe some dry leaves. That's a method I showed in my on my video on how to protect roses over the winter. The fourth and final cause here I'm going to talk about is plants in containers, which may not actually be a cause in itself, but just an exacerbation of everything I've talked about up to this point. Plants in containers have limited capabilities of dealing with the cold. They don't have the moderating effects of the ground to moderate the temperature. They are especially vulnerable to that cut of the wind and also of freezing solid in that pot. So the desiccation can really destroy a plant in a container very, very quickly. When you're talking about those hardiness zones, so even though a plant may be considered, you know, cold hardy to your zone, that if you put it into a container, I think you should at least add a zone or two onto that if you intend to overwinter it outside. But even better, if you can wait until it goes dormant and then tuck it into an unheated location, but is sheltered from the wind and from the rain, you have a better shot of bringing that through the winter. And one of my favorite locations is just my downstairs garage, which really doesn't get heated, but generally stays above freezing anyway. And if I can wait until my roses or other plants are completely dormant before I put them in there, I strip off the leaves, I put them inside, they make it through just fine, at least through the hardest patches of winter. All you have to do is check on them every now and again, just to see that they haven't dried out so completely that the soil is shrinking away from the sides of the pot or the pots have become light. But that's my favorite way of overwintering things in containers. Returning now to the topic of those hardiness zone maps and their usefulness, and of course they are a great starting point to find out if your plant, at least on paper, will survive the cold, the temperatures of your zone, just so long as you keep in mind that it isn't always the cold that kills your plants, and so the onus isn't off of you to make sure that those other things are taken care of. Shelter from wind, keeping your plants out of the winter wet, or making sure the drainage is okay, making sure your plants are healthy going into the winter, those are all on you. There has been a move in recent years to try to factor in some other things into those climate zones. I think the initial 11 zones from the USDA climate map have gone up to about 26 now, and the sunset guide I think has 45 different climate zones that they talk about. So what they've come up with is an increasingly confusing and high resolution way of saying maybe your plants will make it through the winter. I hope that answered some of your questions about what kills your plants over the winter. If you have any other questions or comments, please drop those down below the video. I'll see what I can do to help.